Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, let's give God glory. Hallelujah. Let's offer up a praise of gift. Thanksgiving. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He's been so good to us. Amen. He's such a good father.
Bless your name.
He's such a wonderful daddy. Amen. And I thank him. Hallelujah. For all he's done for us. Amen. For me being personal with it. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Here we go. We're going to ask you to keep your hand clap. Come on, let's bless our God real big. Hallelujah. Hey!
Not before thee. Oh, 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 oh
Hallelujah. Come on and put your hands together for the praise team. Amen. God is so worthy of all the praise. Amen. 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 At this time, nope, won't trick me today. Amen. I'd like to give honor, amen, to Bishop Sylvester and Mother Fanny. Amen. Bishop Rob and First Lady Karen. Amen. Bishop Bob and First Lady Gloria. Amen. Bishop Robert Banks Sr. Amen. National Mother Andrews. Amen. My pastor and First Lady, Bishop Gerald Banks and First Lady Cheryl. Amen. First Lady Miller. Amen. All the ministers, their wives, the deacons. Amen. And to my husband, amen. 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 Yes. Okay. Yes, I wrote it down. Because you get nervous and you forget, and you don't want to forget stuff. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to have our welcome by Sister Anna Banks. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Protocol has already been established, but I'd like to give honor to the best spiritual parents in the world, Bishop Robert L. Banks Jr. and his lovely wife, Karen Banks. It's wonderful, as always, to see all the familiar faces of family, friends, and special guests. Bible Church of God, Indiantown, Okeechobee, wants to send a heartfelt and sincere welcome to all of our members and visitors for joining us with our 24th Annual Women's Conference. We truly, truly welcome you.
Amen. I know you feel welcome now for real. Amen. At this time, Joshua Camp. Amen. Come on, give it up for him.
Test, test. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Mic check.
Let's give praise and worship a hand clap.
Mic check, mic check.
Who's ahead of my life?
Hallelujah.
Honor to my leader and everyone in their respective places. Amen.
Hallelujah. Giving honor to Christ. How y'all doing tonight? Y'all all right? All right. We're going to enjoy ourselves in this women's service. Hallelujah. 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 We're going to do your grace. Is that all right? How many of y'all know it's because of God's grace we still here? Yes, yes, yes. We're going to do your grace. We're going to move right on out the way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
They got you dressed in black and blue.
Yeah. I blame this on my wife. I tried to wear something else, but she wouldn't let me go out the door without it, so I just fell on right on in it. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, don't worry about me. You got to go home.
I learned from the best. I learned from the best. Hallelujah. Let's go. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Come on.
How many of y'all thankful for God's grace? Amen.
Grace.
Before you say my grace. Hallelujah. Say faith.
Yes, sir.
We give a praise. Glory.
If it wasn't for your grace, your love, your heart, that's been covered in me. Say, I'll never be the same no more. Say, I'll never be the same no more. Your grace,
your good,
your love,
your love,
your heart,
your heart,
that's been covered in me. Say, I'll never be the same no more.
No more.
Free and unmarried, unconditional charity. Come on, stolen the grace, his precious brothers inherited. Jesus died on the cross, the redemption of man. Manifested salvation, delivered us from my sins. Be the lowest above all things that walk in prosperity. Thank God for the long-suffering people that buried me. Holy household of faith, my purpose-driven sincerity. Put his love on his plate, keep it consistent with clarity. Trash to the Pharisees, self-righteous comparisons. Judgmental, sanctimonious, similarities. God wrote us the truth, he commanded. That you care for me, your compassion is proof. Never too much to be deaf for me, so let's touch and agree. In planted seed in the prayer for me, man, yeah. What we can be. Deeply rooted in unity, right. Feeble and weak. Breaking doses, yes. Performing requests, is humble and meek. My heart can see the way you want.
Your grace,
your grace,
your love,
your love,
your
heart,
that's been covered.
Hey.
He said,
I'll never be the same no more.
Say, I'll never be the same no more. Your grace,
your grace,
your
love,
your
heart,
that's been covered.
Hey. I'll never be the same no more.
No more.
I'll never be the same no more.
Hey. If my hope is in this world, who knows where I'll be? I'm like most men, living a life full of misery. I thank you for your grace, it kept me in my place. Trusting in your word, now I'm a man of faith. Searching the things hoped for that I can't see, but I hope for the very life of God. Mercy and love, spread abroad. I can't do it on my own, so I give it to God. He's my rock and my fortress, most high. Praise the Lord, I didn't fall by the wayside. He covered me up from selfish. It's because it's grace, I'm forever alive. Full-blooded seed of Abraham coming from the heart. Jesus Christ the Lamb, the Prince of Peace, everlasting Father. The gift of the Holy Spirit, it will never lose its power.
Your grace, your grace, your love,
your love,
your heart,
that's been covered. I'll never be the same no more.
No more,
I'll never be the same no more.
Your grace,
your
grace,
your love,
your love,
your
heart,
my life is destroyed. I know I got to buy to myself to be in your presence. But the storm I got, man, it got me feeling so heavy. I know I can't cool it out, the Lord. I know
Lord,
I
need you,
please hear me, God. I'm surrounded by leashes. I hear the preacher get preaching. My life has to change, but I can't depend on this flesh. That's enough in the game. Second to me and says that this grace is sufficient. But this flesh is so weak, but my spirit is missing than what the spirit is saying.
Cause it's coming across the pulpit.
But this life I'm living, I don't know if I can deal with. Sometimes I feel like I'm losing my mind, but I need a word from the Lord. But
I'm wasting my time.
So Lord, leave me.
Help my unbelief. Never take control of me.
You control my destiny, cause you know what's best for me.
So grace, your Lord,
hallelujah.
Pick up with me,
that I'll never be the same no more.
That I'll never be the same no more.
Your grace,
your
love,
your
love,
your heart,
your heart,
that's pick up with me.
I'll never be the same no more.
No more.
That I'll never be the same no more.
Hallelujah.
Can you say amen?
Hallelujah.
I'm just crazy as I get up, because I believe God will do everything he said he would do.
We bless your holy name.
You're going to start prophesying.
There's no other God like your Father. We thank you for your grace.
Absolutely.
Grace is sufficient to keep us.
Say hallelujah.
If it wasn't for your grace,
your grace,
your love,
your love,
your
heart,
that's been covering me.
I'll never be the same no more.
No more.
I'll never be the same no more.
Your grace,
your grace,
your love,
your love,
your heart,
that's been covering me.
I'll never be the same no more.
Say I'll never be the same no more.
Your grace,
your grace,
your love,
your love,
your heart,
your heart,
that's been covering me.
I'll never be the same no more.
No more.
I'll never be the same no more.
God bless.
Hallelujah.
Thank y'all.
I'll never be the same again. Amen. Anybody that'll never be the same again after the grace and love of God, amen. Amen. Never be the same again. Amen. Amen. Daughters of Zion, amen. You can do better than that. The daughters of Zion, amen.
There's a miracle in this room. We with my name on it. There's a healing in this room, and it's healing.
Well, that's my song right there. That's my song right there.
In this room, it's got my name on it. So I'm gonna put a praise on it. I'm gonna put a praise on it. Somebody put a praise on it. There's a miracle in this room. We touch the name on it.
Watch out, y'all. We gotta get that.
Come on. You might have something you need to put a praise on. Oh, you go ahead and right now and put your praise on it. Oh, it's all right. It's all right. Go ahead and put your praise on it right now. Put your praise on your healing right now. Hallelujah. Put your praise on your breakthrough. Put it on there right now. Hallelujah.
We're going to put a praise on. Oh, we're going to put a praise on. So we're gonna put a praise on it. Yeah, a miracle, y'all. Hey, so we're gonna put a praise on it. My healing, y'all. What you gonna do? So we're gonna put praise. My breakthrough. I don't know. So we're gonna put a praise. So we're gonna put a praise on it. Kick up. So we're gonna put a praise. I'm done.
Oh, don't let her praise God by herself. Come on, you know it's something you need to put a praise on. Come on, come on, come on.
Something to do now.
So we're going to encourage each and everybody, if you can, we want to start this offer off with $25. If you can go with them, we really appreciate it. Come close as you can. So we're going to ask everyone to stand. We're going to ask everyone to bow your head, please. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord God. We thank you for this day, for this is the day that the Lord had made, and we rejoice and was glad in it. Father, we thank you right now for the service up to this far, Father God. We know that you is in the midst of us, and we're giving you the praise, honor, and the glory. Now, Father, we are doing something, God. We are planting on good ground now. Father God, for the seeds to go and grow, to reach soul, Father God, to be a blessing and a help in the kingdom of God. So God, we ask you to bless each, everyone that is able to give, and those that don't have it to give this time, Father God, we pray for them, Father God, that the next time, God, that they will be even have even more to give. So we thank you and we bless you all in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And your liberal giving is appreciated. Amen. At this time, we'll have the scripture by Sister Brenda Bennett. Well, I'm back again. Praise the Lord. We're going to ask everyone to, we're going to read from John the 4th chapter, starting from the 24th verse to the 29th. We're going to ask everyone to stand for the reading of the word. And the word says, God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. The woman said unto him, I know that the Messiah coming, which is called it Christ. When he is come, he will tell us all things. Jesus said to her, I that speak unto thee am he. And upon this came his disciple, and marveled that he was talking with this woman. Yet no man said, what seekest thou? Or why talk thou with her? The woman then left her water pot and went her way into the city, and said to the men, come, see a man which told me all things that I ever did. Is this not the Christ? Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Thank God for the reading of the word.
Amen. We're going to now have the introduction of our speaker. Amen. By Sister Dora Scott. Amen. Come on, encourage her as she comes up. Amen.
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 Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. I give God all the honor, the praise. It is a privilege. I consider it to be a privilege to introduce such a wonderful lady, woman of God. I give honor to my bishop, Bishop Bobby Banks Sr., the overseer of the West Side. I give honor to our bishop of this local assembly, the overseer on this side. I give honor to our general overseer, Bishop Sylvester Banks Sr., all of their wives, missionary saints, and friends. I give honor to you all. Praise the Lord. I have a privilege of knowing First Lady for about 40-something years. And then I'm going to start with me getting to know her during her softball years. First Lady played softball. I was a player also, but I wasn't as good as her. I was good, but First Lady was better. First Lady was awesome, and I admired her for her enthusiasm, you know, playing softball. First Lady left-handed, and I'm going to tell y'all, there's something about those left-handed people. I'm telling you, that woman of God, there, she's bad to the bone. I seen it for myself, and you know, she was a pitcher. I was a pitcher also. But, you know, she just had a way about how she did things. And that's how I first got there. She didn't even know that she inspired me like that. But I watched you all the time. I used to go to your games, and I seen you. So, you know, you was awesome, girl. You was bad. And I had the privilege also to work with her. I worked with her maybe about 10-plus years. And First Lady always had my back. I didn't have to worry about anything because I know I had my First Lady watching over me. So I thank God for her, and also prayer. I pray with this woman of God for about 20-plus years. When I tell you, if you need a prayer partner, if you need someone to intercede for you, call my First Lady. That woman of God, that is a praying woman of God. She can get in touch with God. She hears from God. I found that out for myself. I give glory to that woman of God. She's bad. And you know, I'm going to just share just a little testimony with you guys. You remember the woman that had an issue of blood for 12 long years? Glory be to God. And I had an issue for about 20-plus years. And you know, I was in the church doing our prayer time. And the Holy Ghost spoke to me and said, First Lady got healing hands. Ask her to lay hands on you. First Lady watched me when I was in prayer. And she was curious about why I held my hand a certain way. So she came to me and she said, Dora, why you put your hands there? I say, because I got a problem. So anyway, when God spoke to me and told me that First Lady had healing hands, I say, First Lady, do you remember? I say, lay your hands right there. And I'm telling you, I had an issue for 20-something years, but when the First Lady laid her hands on my body, glory be to God, I was healed immediately. That's why I can say that's a praying woman of God. And she do have healing hands, hallelujah. Because the Bible tell you to lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Glory be to God. And I give honor to this woman of God, hallelujah, because she's special to me, hallelujah. And I love having the privilege to introduce such a phenomenal woman, a virtuous woman like her, hallelujah. I can tell you that she is fearfully and wonderfully made, hallelujah. Glory be to God. And you know, I was thinking about, glory be to God, you know, my prayer time with her. That woman of God can pray. She don't play. Any of y'all that don't know First Lady, get to know her. Hallelujah. Because she will pray you through some stuff. Some stuff that you're going through and you may need a way out. Hallelujah. That woman of God, she will help you get out. Glory be to God. I thank God for her because I made some notes, you know, but I said I just wanted to speak from my heart because I can say so much about her because I had the privilege to walk with her, talk with her, to pray with her. But let me tell you this about my first lady. Any of y'all ever seen her enter a room? Glory be to God. When she enter a room, she got such a finesse about herself when she walk. When she walked, she owned the room. Hallelujah, I love First Lady Wall. First Lady got a bad wall. I believe that what got Bishop attention. That walk. Hallelujah. That ain't the other thing. Hallelujah. She's a spiritual woman of God. Hallelujah. She's a loving woman of God. I love my First Lady. Hallelujah. She awesome. Hallelujah. And I thank God for her. Hallelujah. But I tell you one thing. Hallelujah. Bishop telling me to bring it on home. So as I present to some and introduce to others my First Lady, Gloria Banks, lift your hands all over the building and give God a praise for her. Hallelujah.
Woo! Oh Lord, fire the MC. She ain't on her job. Amen. Sister Dora, you took my paper. Praise the Lord. Amen. The women's choir. Amen. Of Okeechobee, Indian Town, Okeechobee.
Everybody. Amen. Amen. Y'all give our Women of Destiny choir another hand. Amen. Hallelujah. God doing great things in the midst of us. Amen. We in your place of destiny and we being women of destiny. Amen. How many got a purpose and call upon your life? You got destiny to fulfill.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Y'all don't believe that. Y'all don't believe it. How many of you got destiny over your life? Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless God. Okay. We've been practicing. Look, I'm going to make some excuses for us. No, okay, I'll just. All right, here we go.
Thank you, Brother Bill.
nothing. Put them hands together. We want to teach them this. We want to teach you this. Hallelujah. All we saying, bring it down for me, Bill. One minute. Listen. All we saying is, he's the Lord over my life. He's the Lord over my situation. He's the Lord over my heart. He's the Lord over my mind. He's the Lord over my. He's the Lord over my. Come on. He's the Lord.
Glory be to God. God is awesome, isn't he? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, everybody. Hallelujah. First, giving honor to Christ, praise God. Who's first in my life? Thank God for our chief overseer, his beautiful wife, Mother Fanny. Thank God for the man of this house. Praise God. You know, he encouraged me every time I see him. He don't realize that, but he encourages me. A great man of God and his wife. Praise God. Wonderful people. I tell you, wonderful. When I say wonderful, I mean wonderful. Y'all stand and get him a hand of praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's an honor. To always lift your leaders up. It's an honor. Yes. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It is an honor. You don't know what that do to them when you lift them up. Amen. Glory to God. Always see good. Amen. Always see good in your leaders. We be looking for, but look for the good. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Look for the best. Look for the good. Thank God for First Lady Sharon. Praise God. And her husband, Anson. Praise God. Thank God for that. But last, and every pastor, minister, saint, bishop, and friends, thank God for all of you. Glory to God. Praise God. And last but least, say last but least. Hallelujah. Thank God for my bishop, my best friend, my encourager, and a man that love God, and yes, he do love peoples. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You can't love God, don't love people. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yes, yes. Okay. The theme is the beauty of brokenness. Conquering the battle within. Come from John 4:24-29. Glory to God. Let me put it on there. Now, I know you already don't heard or don't got a word from God. The women of God, I know they don't preach. I mean, they don't, you know, encourage us. And I'm here to encourage you. You know, I know the word already came Friday, already came Saturday, but I'm just here to encourage you. Mm-hmm. Through that word that, you know, the women of God has spoken unto you to encourage your life. Now, let us pray. I'm going to pray. Precious Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you right now, Lord Jesus. Oh God, for your grace and your mercy, Lord. Thank you for your people, Lord. Lord, let me, when I open my mouth to speak a word to your people, Lord, let it be through you. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, what you're going to do on tonight, Lord. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. All right. Okay, we're talking about the Samaritan woman. Would you turn to me, Sister Kim, to fourth chapter, fourth verse, and give you an insight on what I'm talking about.
Amen. St. John 4:4. The reading starts as, but he need to go through Samaria. So he came to the city of Samaria, which called Sychar, near the plot of ground that Jacob gave his son Joseph. Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus, therefore, being weary from his journey, sat there by the well. It was about the sixth hour. A woman of Samaria came to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." For his disciples had gone away into the city to buy food. Then the woman of Samaria said to him, "How is it that you, being a Jew, ask a drink of me, a Samaritan woman? For Jews have no dealing with Samaritans."
Now, the reason why she said that, because the Samaritan, it was mixed. And Jesus, you know, he was a Jew, but the Samaritan was mixed. And when she got there, when she said that to him, she was wondering why you want me to give you some water first, and we don't have no dealing.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
So
Jesus answered and said to her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is who say to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. Where then do you give this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob,
yes,
who gave us this well and drink from it himself, as well as his son and his livestock?" Jesus answered and said to her, "Whosoever drink of this water will thirst again, But whosoever drink of the water that I shall give him will never thirst. But the water that I shall give him will become in him a fountain of living, springing up into everlasting life.
She getting, she, now she encouraging or not. Now she, I believe now she is partnering, you know. This is a Jew, but this is a greater one. That was Christ. She pondering now, I believe.
The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water that I may not thirst nor come here to draw." Jesus said to her, "Go, call your husband and come here." The woman answered and said, "I have no husband." Jesus said to her, "You have well said, I have no husband, for you have had five husbands, and the one whom you have now is not your husband." And that you spoke truly. The woman said to him, "Sir, I have perceived that you are a prophet. Our father worshiped on this mountain, and you Jews say that in Jerusalem is the place where one ought to worship." Jesus said to her, "Woman, believe me, the hour is come when you will neither worship this mountain nor in Jerusalem. Worship the Father. You worship what you do not know. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour is coming, and now is when the true worshipers will worship the Father in the spirit and in truth. For the Father is seeking such a worship, to worship him. God is a spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and in truth." The woman said to him, "I know the Messiah is coming, who is called Christ. When he comes, he will tell us all things." Jesus said to her, "I who speak to you am he." And at that point, the disciples came, and they marveled that he talked with a woman, yet no one said, "What do you seek?" or "Why are you talking with her?" The woman then dropped her pot, went her way into the city, and said to the men, "Come see a man who told me all things that I have ever did. Could this be the Christ?"
Okay. Notice when he told her, "This water that you are drink, you know, we get the water, you're going to run out, right? You're going to get thirsty." Notice he told her in scripture, he said, "The water that you drink, this water here is living water. This water here, you are thirsty no more." See, and I believe right then, you know, she had a second thought. So guess what? And I'm saying this to say this. I believe she dropped the pot and she run down there. I don't believe she walked. I believe she went in the city and she told the five men and she told the number six man that wasn't even none of her, somebody else man. Yeah. She said, "Come see a man told me all about myself." See, and see what they did, what happened, and that got incitement because they already know that she wasn't too good. So, yes, they already knew that. So they know there had to be a change within that woman for her to go down there and tell them to come on. So guess what they did? So they say they want to come see, you know, what don't happen, you know, what, you know, I want to see that man for myself. So they say, "Take me there." She went up and brought him back there. Guess what? That's the same thing about the people, about souls. About the souls. That's the same thing. A lot of time we go out and you know we tell people things, but guess what? Everybody ain't gonna get saved. Everybody ain't gonna welcome to that. They hear you. They hear you, but they want you to take them there. Sometimes they say, I tell you what, you take me to church. You know what I'm saying? Because they really want to, you know, believe what you're saying. They say, "Take me to the church. Take me, you know, where I could get what you got." You see? And a lot of times, that's what we got to do. We got to go out there in the hedges and highway.
We got to tell them people. We got to prepare them to come. These are souls. These soldiers out here. People need love. People need love. They need us to grab hold to them and let them know that Jesus loves you. They need us to be a light for them. You know, we can't be a light in the house of God. How are we going to be a light out there? We got to be a light. Yeah. We got to be able to shine. But we can't shine here. We get difficult. But what got me, what gets me, when the things came before me, I learned how to pray. You got to pray every day. See, what happened is you got to drop them things off. You got to make it to the altar. Say, God, I don't want to be in this situation because somebody need me. Somebody need to be saved. You got to drop foolishness off. You got to drop you got to drop unforgiveness off. You got to drop hatred off. You got to drop them things off. You got to drop them adulterous spirits off. You got to bring it to the altar. Say, Lord, I don't want to be in this situation because I can't do your work. I can't do your will in this, in like this. But if you come to the altar and you say, God, I need you to turn some things around because you saved me for purpose. You saved me for plans. You didn't save me to do these things. He saved me because I need a change. Hallelujah. I need a change. And by the change that I have, I can change somebody else. By the love I have, I can love somebody else. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory. He needed. That's why he needed to go by Samaritan. He needed to go there. It was troubled. It was broken. She was broken. The woman was broken. The woman of Samaritan, she was broken. Her people was broken. But she came out there with a light. She came out there with a light. She changed. Her spirit man changed. But we can't change. And I still got my brother in my heart. He might have did a little thing to me. And I still got him. Let go and let God. Let God take over. Take care of them things. It must be a change. You got a little bit. Let me tell you about, you know, happened in my life. The church right over there where, you know, a lot of little children at. And a lot of time we say, child, I want to be bothered with them children. But love draw that. Listen to this. One day them children, they like that. One day going to be like us. I go through that project. They'll run my car down. I go on the other side. They'll run my car down and say, First Lady, can I spend the night with you? I said, yeah, because I want to go to church. You go ask my mama, could I go to church? Could I spend the night with you so I could go to church? You got young women, they need to be encouraged. You got girls, you got new people coming in the house of prayer. You know, they're coming in and they need us to reach out to them and show them love. Not see this and see that. Show them love. They need that. They need to be, you know, you say, well, I don't heard that before. You know why? It's a word of confirmation. You need to hear it again. And again. And again. Till we get right, get again. And again. Because they need us. They need love. They be missing. I don't give them a phone call. Who is it?
They say they do it a lot too.
I say first. You know, they say they get quiet in there. They get quiet. And when I come in, they'll say, first, I'm sorry. Would you pray with me? Would you pray first? I need prayer first. I've been going through. Peoples are going through. Don't let them be by themselves. Don't let them be isolated. They need us. They need us. They need us to encourage them. They need that. They need love. They need companions. They need things of God. Now, if you don't, let me tell you something. If you don't fall in love with God, you can't fall in love with the things of God. The things and places, peoples and things. You got to fall in love with it. Because God is, we got to get out there in the hedges and highway. We got young girls in all the body of Christ. And they need us. They need to be encouraged. They need to be, grab hold to them and take them by the hand and let them know that God lives. God loves them. And I do too. They need that. And the most important thing that we are the leaders. We are leaders. And we got to lead them people and love them. Grab hold to them. Get the hand. And I think about, you know, when the pastor, he give us a word. And a lot of times we say, no, no. She told him. Ain't nobody told him that. That was the word. That was the word of God. Went through the man of God's mouth to help you. Ain't nobody told you nothing. That was God's word. But since we got to grab on to it, we get attitude. No, it ain't gonna work. You be in the same place year after year if you don't get that thing right. Same thing. Same person, same that. Forgiveness is very strong. Forgiveness is good. You know, and I believe that woman got enlightenment when she left that park. All that mess she got in. It look like it does a lightning. It does something to you. When you drop some stuff off and let that mess go. Let it go. It's not anything in God. Let it go. Because we got you people hungry. They need Jesus. They need to be loved. Don't let it pass you by. Don't let it pass you by. Because the day you say that, and Bishop Rod run the revival, and everybody was coming up, and they said they're going to go out and witness and do that, you know, and get the life straight. But if you still got them same strongholds on you, you can't do it. Bring it to the altar and let it go. Bring it to the altar. Bring it to the altar and let it go. Because I want to be a winner. See, God say, you know, we think we all us in here, everybody in here, God got purpose and plans for our life. He saved all us for such a time as this. This is our season of BCOG to go out and get the harvest. It's plentiful out there. The labor of fruit. Go out there and get them. People need to be saved. People need love. You start loving, man, they're going to bring in, oh my God. But the people are sitting on the edge now. And we ain't doing nothing. I'm not saying the prophet sometimes. We ain't doing nothing. And they want you to come by. A lot of times, like my bishop say, when you know, they join all kind of stuff. They join this, they join that, they join that, because they're looking for us. And we nowhere to be found. That's why they join up with all these different religions and different, all that different, because we ain't doing right. We ain't doing right. And that's what it's all about. It's about them souls. It's about people, y'all. It's about people. They need us. They need us. They need us to let them know. They need us so much. They need us so bad. And what I do, I go into the store. They say I love Walmart. But I'm going in there and I'm being a witness to people. I take a girl to work every day. Miss Baines, you not know, baby, you all right. She said, my baby want to come to church. She want to get in the choir. See, you know, love and kindness have I draw thee. That's what love does. It draws. It draws. That's what love does. You got babies. You got little children. They understand. Yeah, they understand. But what we got to do, we got to go out there and get them. It's plentiful. It's plentiful. And get my sister by the hand. We, you know, we be in a conversation. Let that special sister come by. Did he go grab that sister? Say, I love you. He might not mean to go grab her again. I love you. Every time you see, I love you. After ride, something gonna break. You got to continue with doing the will of God. You got to continue to do what God has us to do. You got to keep doing it. I keep praying. If I'm all by myself, it was 25, 17, but I still got to go to the house of Bethel. I can't stop. I can't quit. I can't give up. I can't give in. I have to still go to the house of Bethel because the enemy, he want to destroy. That's what he want to destroy. If he can destroy that, he got it. If he destroyed the church, I'm telling you, he got it. But that prayer, I tell you, it'll block it. It'll block them things. It'll block the things of the enemy. It'll block the plot up. It'll block that confusion. That's what prayer does. That's what prayer does. And that's why we got to keep doing, keep praying, keep fasting. And most of all, you pray for your leaders. Because if he can get the head, he know he got the tail. But if he can't get that head, he know he can't get the tail. But that's what we got to keep our faith, keep our spirit, you know, right. Keep our spirit right before people. They need a light on your job. They'll follow you. They'll say, you'll put me in the boss, they'll follow you. If you're a light at the job, we don't be one of them sisters. Oh, she go to that church. Child, she messy. That's what they say. Ooh, she messy. What church you say she go to? She messy. But you wouldn't get that sister say, boy, I tell you, that sister was there for me through thick and thin. She prayed for me. And a lot of time we ain't got to go and broadcast. I'm saved. I'm a believer. You ain't got to do that. People see that. You just live it. They'll see it. Live that light. They'll see it. Then they want to be a part of that. We need one another. I don't need to be fighting against you and fighting. Oh, you don't make up. You ain't praying. That's why. It's easy to get there if you ain't praying. Let me tell you something, y'all. I'm serious. That prayer, it will block something. A lot of stuff you may see, you won't even see it. If you continue with that prayer life, you won't even see it. You're going to want to do something for the Lord. Lord, what you have me to do? What is it for me to do? Lord, I need to tell somebody that you live. I need that. Lord, I know you died that I may live. I know that. And the love that you had, this man here, he betrayed him, Judah. But Jesus yet still loved. He came back in the spirit. And that's where we got to be. We got to keep on keeping each other encouraged and loving on them new converts. Them young girls, they're coming in here and they looking for something. And you know, I'm telling the whole body, they're coming in and they're looking for somebody that's going to keep them encouraged and somebody going to love them, take them by the hand and tell them they're wrong. They already, you know, not telling you already know you're wrong. But guess what? Love will drive that. You ain't got to say nothing to them. They'll say, you first, you know, I might have, you know, put them to shop, but I'm sorry first, you know, but I'm serious. Now do that. I'm going to do better first. I'm sorry. So a lot of time people try you and see where you at. See, you really got the faith, but we got to keep ourselves in order. And keep loving on our leaders. Don't always find some. We find so much. We smell so much in our leaders. That's fine, fine, fine. And all you got to do is get with them and pray with them. And be good people. Wonderful people. Get one of them. Come on, first lady, you pray for me. I'm talking all the first lady. First lady, would you pray? I'm going through some things. That's everywhere. Not always pointing. We point too much. Point upon us. And then that's the way that we're going to be able to. Thank you. We're going to be able to encourage one another. Then we don't need people scared to come around us. Oh, Lord. We don't need that. We need to be encouraged. Encourage the ministers. Encourage the deacon. They need to be encouraged. Everybody need to be encouraged, especially our leaders. They need to be encouraged. Yes. Everybody need to be encouraged. We need one another. I need you. I need you and you need me. That's my word. I need you and you need me. I ain't hiding you and you ain't hiding me. We right here together. That's my word. That's that my word. Take care of your leaders, man. Take care of them. Take care of them. Them your spiritual parents, your spiritual father, your spiritual woman of God. Come on. Grab them by the hand sometime. put a little something in the hand. I don't care if they got it, but put it in the hand. And be a witness, you know. And then a lot of times we say, well, I don't know how to witness, you know. You know, you got Romans 10:9. It says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thy heart God had raised Jesus from the dead, thou shalt be saved. You don't know that scripture, you got tracks. You got some. But people need what you got. They need what you got, but a lot of time it is true. Sometimes we don't really know how to, you know, witness, you know. But this is a witness for you. It'll tell you what'll happen if you don't get it right. It'll tell you. You need to get it right. That's what we need this for. And I thank God. I thank God for who he is. I thank God for who he is in your life. I thank God for who he is in my life. And I thank God for where he's taking us in this season. Because the men of God is really preaching and teaching us on going out in the hedges and highway and preparing. Because it's time to prepare and love. Yes, Lord. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. It's about love. Thank you, Lord. We see too much. We see too much. Sometimes we need blindfold over the eye. We see too much. Just a praying about some things. We see too much. Still us encouraging one another. We see too much. God is an on-time God. I love God, peoples. When they come to me, say, so-and-so, I said, baby, look, let me tell you something. I said, God got a mandate on your life. No, so I said, God got works. He got plans in you. No. That's helping. I'm helping that person. All that's in you, I'm trying to pull it out. Because we seen too much what they did. Baby, you're going to be all right. God got work for you to do. Work. While it's day, work. If we work, we won't see all that. Be too tired. Too tired. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Work. I've been retired. It is going on 2 years. And I thought I had all that work in my job. Oh, Lord, go home. Ooh, my Lord. I'm working, y'all. I'm working. I'm going some places I've never been before. I'm doing some things I never did before. I'm full-time doing the will of God. That's it. This is it. Because we great people. Amen. And God could have saved somebody else, but he saved us because we could get the job. He know we're going to get the job done. He know we're going to go in them heads in the highway. Thank you. In my closing. Yes. My closing, y'all. You that want to do better, you know, we might be laughing and whatever. You that want to do better, you that want your leader, your bishop to be, our bishop to be so proud of us, come to the altar today. Come now. I don't want to be in this situation. I want to be an encourager. I want to be a light to the world. I want to be a light before God's peoples wherever I go. I can't do nothing with baggage on me, them strong things, the strongholds. I want to be like the Samaritan woman. She left that.
She received her salvation. She left it. She become a great woman. So today you say, why can't I? I can do all things through Christ that strengthen me. I'm going to be the one that go into the hedges and highways and prepare men to come. Because I need my sister, because guess what? We stronger together. In the hedges and highways. We need to change our direction. Our thinking, our thought. Get the thought of my leader. My leader don't share the word. Gave me a word for my life. Wednesday night, Sunday. And I've been just putting it away. But today, I want to do what God want me to do. Because I can't help nobody in that same way. In the spirit of unforgiveness, in the spirit of I don't care. I can't get nowhere like that. But today, I'm coming to drop them things off that's not like God. And I'm going to let God guide my life. This is what I'm going to do today. Stand with me, you all.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
You that wants to do better, would you come forth today? You that want to give up that, would you come forth today? Them things that I just wouldn't turn loose, that wasn't like God. I might have did some things. I might have said some things that I know I didn't mean. But today, I want to do better. Today, I got friends at school, and they need to see a light within me. They need to see that I can help them. Move in a better way. Be a better person. Tell somebody that Jesus loves them, and I do too. And I admit that. God, forgive me for all my sins, all my wrongdoing, all my wrong thinking. I need you, Lord. Today, Lord, I need you. I need a change. There's better things for me. There's greater things for me. But I have to have a change in my life.
sponsoring.
Come on, God. I want him to be my God. I want to be a different person. Because I serve a true and living God. This is that why I'm at the altar. I'm dropping some things off. The pot of life. Won't be the same anymore. It's my time. My season.
Death could not hold me down.
Jesus,
rain.
You are the rainbow king.
See the majesty. That's why we praise you, God. You are the rainbow.
Yeah.
bless your name, God. We give it, Lord Jesus. You have not hold me. That cannot hold my heart.
I'd like to thank you all for the opportunity to be here today with you. I appreciate you. Amen. 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 It's a part of the story I never told anybody in the Bible Church of God. But I'm going to tell y'all today, when I joined y'all church, somebody said, why you with them people? Okay. I'm not from Palm Beach County. I'm way from Broward County, so I don't know what it. Oh, you'll never do nothing at they church. Your last name ain't Banks. I said, okay. I said, okay. Yeah. Then they say, oh, well, Bishop Gerald just like you. You know, okay. Amen. And when Minister Hakeem was at Palm Beach Lakes, they really gave it to me then. Amen. Oh, I took it. It was all right. Oh, you let him do what he wanted. First of all, he's a grown man with sick days. He take off when he want to. Amen. He the only employee that tell me when he going to be off in advance. Amen. Rest of y'all just don't come to work. Amen. Amen. But I'm standing here today. Amen. I hope the person that told me that, amen, those of you that went live, I hope they saw it. If not, I'll call them and let them know. Amen. 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 I appreciate you all. Amen. At this time, the hospitality, and after them, the man and woman of this house. Amen. Amen.
Good job.
Oh, my God. You blessed us. Yes, Lord. I'm going to fire y'all. Get your butt over here, man. Tyrone, God dog it, you better pay attention,
amen.
Boy.
On behalf of our hospitality committee, just to show you guys, I'm talking about love and appreciation for your time and service, for coming out today and blessing us with your presence. We know we can't bless you with much, but I guarantee you some great gifts in this bag. Because you know Sister Linda like to do it big. I hope you guys enjoy your gift. We love you, and we thank you again for coming out and blessing us. Amen.
Ready? Praise the Lord. All right, Tyrone, come up from under the hat. Blue. I'm going to have to take that hat from you, boy. My God. All right, Tasha, call him. Call him. I'm talking to his wife. You know you're telling him what to do anyway. Call him.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
That's good. Great service, huh?
Amen.
Great service. Yeah. Been good all week. Clap your hand for Sister Gloria first. Yeah. That's my sister right there, man. Nobody messes with Sister Gloria. You don't mess with her. That's my sister. She loved God, huh? Yeah, she loved God. Thank God for it. And sometimes when, you know, God call you to do something, and most times, you know, you see people up, and, you know, most times we see it ain't no show. You see people's hearts. And, when you're real, your heart got to come out. You know, but if you done just getting something good, somebody to hear it so it can make you look good, then it don't produce life. Father, the good treasures of a man's heart, and may they speak. Amen. And I, you know what reminded me of this conference, women conference, been good. They've been preaching, sister. First lady on last night. First lady Sonya from Tampa Friday night. Then my buddy and friend here, Sister Cheryl, and they tore some stuff up. And then you know what? When I thought that was all you can get out of that, Sister Gloria came and got a little bit of it. That was good. You know the scripture says she went back and told the men of the city. Sister Glory says she went back to them five men. Preach, girl. That's right. When God done changed you, go back to them folk that you done hurt. That's good. And let them know that you done dropped the water pot. And now you tell them, come see a man. Ain't nothing like y'all. Amen. Another man. I met the right man now. But that was a good message. Thank God for the conference. Clap your hand for all of them. Yes. Mr. Ceremony. Hi. Great job. God bless you. Amen. Thank God for you. And it's been refreshed. You know, I'm reminded of our conference. This verse of scripture that comes from the book of Proverbs say, he that refreshes others shall of themselves be refreshed. I like that. That's a good verse of scripture. If you ever want to be refreshed in your life, start refreshing other people. Just start blessing other people. And so that's what I tell folk that's here. Anytime God give us an event, and then you refresh other people. You refresh other people in God, and in turn, he will refresh you. And I just thank God for it. And that's what it's been. I sense a spirit of refreshing and a spirit of deliverance, and I sense a spirit of friendliness. I see, amen, see the spirit of God moving in the midst of us. Thank God for everybody. We're in our closure. And we thank God for everybody, all the saints of God. Yes, yes. Thank God for everybody. Very good. Before we let you go, come on, Sister Gloria, do this for me. Put a bucket in her hand, please. Put a bucket in her hand. Amen. And we're going to seed in her life. We're going to seed in her life. Let's seed on that word that she ministered in our lives. Amen. Amen. Let me unloose some shackles off some people. The reason why we do this is because we want to present an opportunity that you can sow seeds in other people's lives. We know that if you sow seeds, God will bless you. And this ain't nothing you got to do. Now, if you just don't want to do it, then don't do it. What we're going to do, my wife and I, we're going to bless her. We're going to bless her. We're going to bless her enough she can go out and eat her steak dinner. We're going to do that. So now we're going to present an opportunity for you to come and just sow some seeds on that word that she took out time to seek God for to bless us with. All right? Do that. Get your offering. Rest on your feet. And just routinely come and just put the offering in that for a seed on that word. God bless you. Thank you very much. All right, boy. Yes. Yes. You got something to say? Thank you, thank you, thank you. 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 Amen. Thank you, thank you. Thank you. Anyone else? Anyone else? Tell them I'm a giver, man. Come here, come here, come here, come here, come here. I know you heard me right there. Thank you right there.
That right there.
That right there. See that stand right there, right there. That's right. That's right. See that? See? That's why I want you to move till I tell you to move. See? See that to my sister Sherry, see? All right. Thank you. Anyone else? Anyone else? Show forth your hand this way. In Jesus' name, thank you for the seed that has been sown today. We so thank you for the word that you are giving us. We believe our increase is in this word. The money, the finances is in the mouth of the fish. Thank you for giving us a word. You make us fishermen of men. We sow in her life, we sow in that word that it might produce the harvest that you are expecting. And we give you praise, and we give you thanks, we give you honor. In Jesus' name, we declare increase. And the saints say, amen. Amen. God bless you. Make it from her.
Now you can
move now. Yes, you can move now. Go ahead.
Amen.
All right, I'm going to do this and I'm done. Clap your hand for my bishop. Honor first Mother Fanny. I really do honor them. Thank God for them. Amen. Thank God for them. I do. I really honor. I do what I'm called to do, but I know I got a covering in the head. And I thank God. And amen. Amen. I do what I'm called to do. And a lot of these jobs I ain't asked for, but I do what I'm called to do. And I thank God for this man and this woman of God and how God used them. They are our covering, and we do thank Amen. God for it. Amen. Amen. And Bishop Bobby, thank you.
Amen.
Central Overseer, Lake Wales, God bless you. First Lady that spoke today. We thank God for all the First Ladies. New Jersey, raise your hand. Steffi, God all bless right. you. She gave us a little testimony on Saturday night. Yeah, she preached. Yes, Lord God is doing some stuff in there. First Lady Miller.
All right.
Delaware. West Palm Beach.
All right.
Amen. Boynton Beach. We thank God for everybody in their respective place. Everybody. Hope I didn't miss out anybody. Thank God for you. Clap your hand for the lady that's over our women's auxiliary, Sister Beverly. Yeah. Beverly Banks. Come on, put them hands together. Give God a praise for
her. Amen.
Sister that love God. Love God and work well with leadership. She don't want to go over no leadership. Sometimes worry me a little bit too much. But she want to make sure that she in one accord with leadership. And that's why the Lord led us to get her over these auxiliaries.
Amen.
And then the women that are around her, I want to say thank y'all.
Amen.
Thank you. And I can't call all y'all name, boy. I can't call all y'all name. Y'all know who you are, man. And you thank God for you. And that's how the body of Christ should function. We one body, but we many members. Thank God for you, loving on you. Keep us in your prayers and pray for it that we do what God calls us to do. My wife, Sister Banks, put your hand together.
Amen. 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 I do honor the Lord. We're not going to hold you, but I just want to say something. I do honor the Lord. As you say, protocol have already been called. Our chief, I asked about y'all this morning. We were coming to some school. I said, well, where's my bishop and mother Fanny? Because I know y'all will be here. Amen. Amen. Just want to thank God for everybody. Our mistress of ceremony. Just everybody. And I want to give a special thanks to our spiritual daughter. Raise your hand, Tarina. Tarina Merv. I mean, not Mervin. Shaheed.
God bless you. God bless you.
I looked over there and saw her. Amen. I thank God for you. Thank God for everybody. We don't want to leave nobody out.
Amen.
Our mothers.
our missionaries, Daughtry, National Mother. One thing about National Mother, she gonna come, she gonna find us, y'all.
Amen.
I don't care where we go, she gonna be right there. Then she be getting up shouting, then can't hardly walk out of church. But she be here. Thank God for that. Yeah. Amen. Thank God for the musicians. Come on.
Musicians.
Amen. Amen. Bible everybody. Sure. I see my nephew. Glad to see you, Yuvaske Cunningham. Amen. We just thank God for the kitchen staff. Oh, they've been feeding us. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. After we get that spiritual word, then our bellies get full and natural. We thank God. We don't want to leave nobody out. We thank God for the sound media staff, the sound man, even though they don't pay attention half the time. But we thank God for everybody. Oh, I so enjoyed the sisters, man, this weekend. You all really don't know how you helped me this weekend. You really blessed me. Thank God for the women of this house. Amen. Come on, give them a hand. Amen. I enjoyed myself. I really did. I left my husband, y'all, because I want to be here and to be a servant. Amen. To be amongst the saints. And we thank God for everybody that just stayed over the whole weekend. I just really had me a ball. For real. Like Mother said, family say, for really. For really. For really. I had me a ball. I really did.
They got you, Mama. They got you.
I love everybody. I enjoyed everybody. Amen. Amen. When we did set a date, okay. Up come I'ma hurry up. Yes. Up come Matthew. Amen. But God knows all things. Them that wait upon the Lord. See how God blessed us in this time? We changed the date 2 times. But look what God done. Come on, give yourself a hand. We love y'all. God bless you.
All right.
He can say what he want to be when he's rushing me up. Anyway, go ahead.
Stand up on your feet.
Thank God. All our churches.
I'm glad your name ain't Apostle Carol.
Amen.
All right. Thank God for everybody. We love all.
Amen.
I got the best spiritual family in the whole world.
Amen.
God bless you. I know I got spiritual families everywhere else, but, and I know we're going to get to know one another better when we get to heaven, but I'm getting to know y'all right now. We're working together, and when we go to heaven, we're going to get rewarded together because of the work we're called to do. Lift that hand now towards heaven. Let's do our benediction. Oh, the theology word is called. Yes. If y'all got time, I got it.
Hallelujah.
I got it. Okay. Come on, Teddy. Come on, Teddy. They want an update on what's been happening with the. Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Just an update. We, with the Corey case, we had a recent court hearing on the last week. A little nervous. 2 weeks ago, and we had another status check, and he, the judges wanted him to speed the case up. He's still on house arrest, of course, and they're going through depositions now on both sides, so they have to do depositions for 150 people. So they're saying now our next court hearing is on the February 22nd. So then she wants them to basically check in again and see how far they've gotten. Then after 2 more months, we should get a trial date. And they're expecting the trial to begin around the 1st of June. We want you guys to keep us in prayer. This is a journey that we're on. I didn't realize, and I'm sure the family didn't realize it was going to take this long, but it is a process because of how the system is set up. The system is not set up for the citizens.
Yeah.
It's set up for the jury, It's a system that's not in place for the citizens. So you just pray that the Lord break down some barriers in that system because it's not fair. Yeah. We've been working diligently with Palm Beach Gardens. You know, Palm Beach Garden fired him after two months, and he got fired from his other job. And we've been trying to bridge some gaps with Palm Beach Gardens. They want us to know how sorrowful they are for that one officer that decided to shoot and kill Corey that night. So we've been working with them. It's been difficult. We've been trying to build some partnership with them. We had a golf tournament last week. Some of the ministers were at the golf tournament. We mm-hmm. had a great turnout. Mm-hmm. Our next event is coming up on the 19th. They're calling it, it's a Unity Day, Palm Beach Garden and Anita Banks Justice for Corey Foundation Unity Day. Mm-hmm. And they're going all out. They have games, all kind of things that they're doing, and they're inviting the community, they're inviting the family, they're inviting the body to come out and join with them as they want to show us how they feel about what happened to Corey. They want to show us, the police department wants to show us how they feel about Corey. So they're going all out, all expense, bearing no expense. We have the Muff group is going to be performing, James Smith, the dance group, a lot of the dance groups. They have all kind of food, fun, all kind of stuff they're doing on that day. So we invite you guys to come out. It's from 1 to 5. And we ask you guys to please come out and support us and just enjoy the evening.
Hey, how y'all doing? Yes, just to add to what you're saying, Palm Beach Gardens have went over and beyond. I think it's a win-win situation for them, and they took advantage of it. And they have fallen to embrace and love our family. They really have embraced our family. And they don't know to this day how we keep coming up there, sitting at the table. And every day we get off the ramp, we look to the right, and there's a burial site there. Then we go to the city, and then we sit down and still be able to conduct business. We're showing them what our father have taught us and what we've been raised with. And they are in awe. Every time we go to a meeting, I mean, we've been going to meetings like every Friday for the last, since probably June, since May, I believe. And they just, I mean, God is working in Corey's death. It is phenomenal. And you guys are get a chance to see this. And I believe that what he's doing is he's making this situation a template for the nation. And I think that's what we're selling. I think it's going to be, I mean, this event going to be a really good thing for the world to see, and especially our county. And we're not going to stop there. We're going to go to the sheriff's department. We're going to start, you know, making sure that hopefully we can be an allocated for them to get body cams. Oh, we're going to Bradshaw. We're going to everybody. We're going to everybody. We're going to make this a big deal because they took somebody out of our body. They took our musician, our nephew, our sons, you know. So we're going to make a big deal out of it. So if y'all get tired of seeing us on TV or seeing rallies or seeing press conferences, well, get tired of it because we're not going to stop. We're going to keep doing it. We're going to make a big deal out of, you know, when you kill somebody in our family, you know, you're going to pay for it. You're going to pay for it publicly, and then we're going to pray that God, I've already have forgiven the guy, but we want to make a big deal out of it. And we need you guys' support. We really need you guys' support. Not a phone call, not all of, we need your presence if you can be there. Also, the last thing, we're putting together with, on the 19th, November the 19th, we're putting together a 100 voice choir. It's been very difficult to get a rehearsal, but we're planning on maybe singing 3 or 4 songs. And listen, please, if y'all just can come in, join in, just be a part of it. We're trying to get on your voice because we're trying to make a statement. We really want this to be an annual thing, and that's what we're trying to sell. So we want to make it as big as possible, and we want to make sure that our end is covered. So they'll always remember Corey, just like they were known to Alamo and all these other things. So that's what we want. That's pretty much what our drive is. And we're never going to quit. We're going to stay consistent. And we're going to pray that God give us victory. Thank you. God bless you.
God bless. God bless. God bless. Stretch forth your hand as well. Let's pray for them. In Jesus' name, favor rest on them. Give them courage. Give them wisdom. Give them direction. I pray, God, that you're leading of them, God, that come from you, God. Give them right direction, Father. Give them right information. Help them to do, God, what you called them to do. Let your bidding be done in the midst of this situation. We intercede on their behalf in the name of Jesus for the glory of God. Everybody say amen. Lift that hand. Let's do the doxology. Ready? Let's say it. Now unto him which is able to keep you from falling, present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. Only one, who it is, our Savior, be glory, majesty, power, and power, both now and forever. And the demon of God say, shake somebody and tell them you love them. God bless you.